Hello and welcome everyone to the first episode, the first official cast of Into the Fountain. This is going to be mine and Decoy's weekly talk show, just kind of getting some players in the community, community members that are well recognized in here, doing some fun interviews, having some fun, and just enjoying the day. So first thing I really want to touch on is the sibling rivalry. We have ShadowQ and Macetodaface joining us. They are brothers playing on two competitive teams. ShadowQ, the left lane support for Curse, carries Pon Pon all day long. Macetodaface, the mid player for Denial NA, one of the two teams that just emerged this past 2 weeks. Really exciting to see you guys playing. Happy as hell to have you all here with us, too.
Yeah, happy to be here.
The first thing I really wanted to touch on was this little sibling rivalry that we've seen kind of emerging between the two teams. You two trying to kill each other as much as possible in games, or at least poking at each other.
Yeah,
so I've got a couple clips lined up here, and I'm going to add this in and run the clip really quickly. They're two very short clips from last week. Unfortunately, we don't have the ones from this week, but maybe someday we will get those in here if you guys join us again soon. But this first one I'm going to get in here is at the 26-minute mark of the first match your two teams ever had against each other. And just to... I'm going to roll the clip.
This doesn't look like it's going to go well for me.
Yeah, just taking a look at that health.
Just look at the numbers at the top.
Oh, I remember this actually. No.
That health. That health. So I'm going to hit play.
Is he even start off at 5%? I mean, let's be honest.
Let's just take a look really quickly. Shadow goes diving in, and oh no, that one happened. So first kill between you two. This joking sibling rivalry that we've gotten kind of set up. Went to Mace with the help of the tower, but...
Nah, that was all me. I mean, Shadow's just so bad.
I'm terrible, man.
Yeah. So, the second one was right here. Every clip I seem to have, you're such low health, Mace. But this one, Shadow's gonna dash in and pick up that kill. So, the thing I really just wanted to, like, point out was this... entertaining, to say the least, sibling rivalry that you two have kind of developed.
Oh, I remember
developed.
That. Yeah, I stole that kill on purpose.
Yeah, exactly. And I was talking to Pon. I'm like, so how about that last kill that Shadow took from you right before the end of that first match the two teams had together? And Pon's like, oh, when that happened, I was actually laughing because it was I thought it was so funny. And I'm like, dude, it's your brother. I expected more kills to be stolen from me. Hey. I just thought it was really entertaining to watch you guys going back and forth. And, like, this week I want to get an update. We were ready to go. We had the admins pull it, so it went onto the main stream. And right before it went onto the main stream, we had it updated with the sibling rivalry, who's got the most kills.
Oh, that's cool.
So
who's in the lead right now?
It was 1-1. I don't know. I don't know who's the most up-to-date.
I don't think we killed each other at all, as far as I remember.
So the battle continues.
Yes.
I mean, we really noticed it last week. Shadow was definitely going after you.
Oh, yeah.
You got.
It was funny to watch.
It was just like, oh, man, just forget all you fools. Yes.
Yeah, focus Mace.
And I could almost get, like, I could see it. As soon as you killed him, there was, like, a scream. You know what I mean? Like, like, what you got now? You know? Oh, I love it.
Going across the house, you could hear the victory screeches. I'm sure your parents enjoyed that. Like,
oh, they love it.
Well, go on, sorry.
Well, for a while, like, we would both play in the basement. Like, we have two computers side by side. So, like, we would have to tilt our screens away from each other so we couldn't see.
No, you can't screen look at me. No, you can't screen look at me. Hey, yeah. I take it you guys move just to be respectful and not have the...
And we're not shouting over each other.
Yeah. You two shouting over each other.
Deal, though. I think Mace down in the basement's got the nice, cool, like, you know, he's away from everybody.
Here, I'll actually show you real quick if I cannot mess up my webcam. Like, this setup.
Oh, yeah, our setup? Oh, like, man.
If I don't know if you can see.
Oh, that Diablo 3 poster.
We have three posters there.
In it down.
Yeah, but it's pretty nice down here. Good for playing together when we're not trying to
kill each other.
Yeah.
So that's like, what, on Tuesdays?
Yeah, we have just one day set aside where we don't kill each other.
Yeah.
And the rest of the week, it's like at each other's throat.
Yeah. Yeah, pretty much.
But yeah, so it's definitely 1-1. I mean, you know, no kills today. Okay, we'll
supposedly
see you next
no
week.
Kills. Yeah, I'm going to still go through the VOD.
It's going to be, you never know. I mean,
kill count of your family going.
I mean, I should be ahead. I mean, I play a carry.
Well, my goal as a left-handed support is often to just try to trap the mid out of place. Now I'm going to give that just a little more focus.
Just level 1, no farming, just sit in mid, all 5.
Yeah.
Who needs to farm?
As long as it gets me a kill on you, it works.
Exactly, that's the only goal. You don't even need to farm. You could just go mid from now on, and it could be you two jousting while Best plays side lane support.
There you go.
Yep. I'll play tank at mid. That'll work.
Okay, yeah. And he could practice some of that hubu support on left lane. I'll have to teach him my build.
You gotta teach him.
I just played Odin support in a normal conquest. It was hilarious. They had an Agni, and I just chapped him, killed him right at 5.
Oh, like I should do to you next week?
Oh! Ooh!
That's not talk too strong!
Now you have to do it, like, so...
Alright, it's done.
So we've got at least one pick determined, or two picks, I guess. Mace, you have to be Agni, and Shadow, you have to be Odin.
Okay, no banning those guys.
Yeah, exactly. You'll have to plan
Bubble
that
Boy
one out.
Now. Bubble Boy Odin coming out. Gonna do work.
Oh my god, so, I hate the Bubble Boy.
Pretty much, if you don't honor that, your guys are DQ'd.
Yep. I'll take it.
I like where this is going.
This is now in the rules. It's official in an unofficial manner.
Exactly.
It's official in our eyes.
Exactly.
Yeah, there we go.
So, next thing, moving on from the sibling rivalry, the fun. Today's match... hang on 1 second, updating the title. Really, I mean, it's good for Root. I'm happy for them. I was really surprised to see how it panned out. Shadow, how did it feel? I mean, I guess it must have been tough, but to see Curse losing their first monthly.
Well, I think that was the weekly. I think the monthly's tomorrow.
Weekly. Yeah. Sorry.
Yeah,
thank you.
Yeah. Yes. But still, that was our first defeat since the Curse tournaments came out. It was a little upsetting, but we knew it was going to happen sooner or later.
Yeah.
And if we were going to lose to a team, Root would be the one we're going to lose to.
Yeah.
So Andister, really surprising. I mean, Root's had a lot of change-ups this week. With Allied leaving last Sunday, I expected Allied to leave. It seemed like he was getting a little bit on edge. But Shing, that came out of nowhere.
Yeah, I don't know the exact details, but I think he had some personal stuff going on,
too.
He
was told school or personal,
just
something along those lines.
Yeah, I mean, the Allied leaving probably had something to do with it. Like, it at least set it off.
It was a lot of strong-willed players on the team. And I think that was kind of, like, the big thing this week. It's Anatoly, like, he's got a strong will, but he's willing to, like, ease up and let the rest of the team take the reins as needed.
Absolutely.
And, and Shing was also very, very strong, but Andister, I think, coming into it all, he's going to be a little bit quieter, easier going, all things considered, so that's going to be kind of where Root falls into place with, like, them finally having that flowing team comp.
Keep in mind, you're still betting that Andister's moving over. You know what I mean?
At this point, I have my money on it. After today's victory,
after
I think...
Today, no, don't get me wrong. It's a huge, you know what I mean, like, definitely Root, you know, they want to look at that and be like, yeah. And plus, he did carry. You know, he did very, very well as Freya. You know what I mean?
All the games he played, I think, were Freya, or at least all the ones that I had a chance to see. And he went up positive every single one of them. Like, I think his worst game that I saw was 5-3.
But, you know, definitely I'm happy to see Denial. Denial and A.
Denial. Moving on to Denial.
We secretly root for you guys.
I've been cheering for you guys for the past 2 weeks.
I think you guys need to step it up and put a little more bias into it. Just be like, ooh, that was just a lucky ulti there. Whenever Curse does something well, just don't give him any credit.
Hey, we do our best to really stay right in the middle. We're always back and forth, you know what I mean?
I think like it came up as a comment from Rastarian quoting me about Zap Manning. I had quoted Matty Pocket, so I was quoting Root, and it came up that I quoted that, and I knew it was going to happen the second I said it, but It was like, whatever, you know, I'm going to put it out there. So they they commented on it. It came up, and I was...
I don't even want to talk about that post on the subreddit.
My God. Oh, my God. It was rough.
There was a lot of hate in that post.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Some of it's justified. Don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
The first half, sure.
You know,
I can validate it.
Exactly. Half of it felt really solid, and the other half just felt mean.
It was kind of personal attacks.
Especially with the Zat Manning thing, like that was one time, and even if you were saying that,
actually,
like,
it was about two or three quotes where it came out.
Yeah.
But I mean, we were trying to add a little humor and fill dead air, and I mean, that's how casting goes.
Yeah, I mean, it's really not like a big deal. It's not like you're doing it every game all the time.
But when I said it, it was like, oh, it sounds like I'm rooting for Curse, which was really ironic because I was cheering for Denial NA that match because
yeah,
I was ready to see someone beat Curse.
Yeah.
And so I'm like,
oh, thanks for your support, Santa.
I love you, Shadow.
Every week, baby. Every week, we do it.
It's okay, Shadow. I support you with my Hoobu play.
It's been like,
That's fair.
We faced Curse like in the second round, like the last three tourneys, I think.
Yeah.
Like, it's always like we get one team that we're pretty confident going into the first round, and the second round we see that we're against Curse, and it's just like, great.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I mean, I was ready, like, for weeks now I've been saying, this is the week that Curse will be upstaged once it's going to happen, and every week I've been not surprised when you guys win.
Next week, obviously.
Obviously.
Yeah, next week Denial is going to be one.
I would like to see, what are your guys' thoughts on Worth It, the team, like, as a whole? I mean, have you scrimmed against them, or, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
like,
they're pretty strong right now, I think.
Okay.
They're definitely strong, but we haven't really, like, scrimmed them. Like, it seems like we always tend to, like,
we actually
scrimming the same teams.
Excessive amount, yeah. But so, from when we have faced them, they're definitely pretty strong.
Mace, I have kind of a question for you, actually.
Okay.
First match, they made their debut today. How did you feel about Easy Team?
The game against Easy Team, I don't know, like, they had a decent early game, as you'll see with a lot of new teams. Like, I mean, we're still kind of in this phase. Mm-hmm. Like, it was back and forth in the early game.
Yeah.
But then, as we got into the late game, like, that's when we really started to come ahead and break away from them. And, I mean, I think they could be a good team, but they definitely need to get on that mid to late game and really converge.
They had an amazing early game. I was impressed.
Game.
I mean, they were up 3 kills at one point, and I was just like, wait, whoa.
Yeah.
New team showing up. They had never really scrimmed with anyone. The only practice they had was from Conquest matches. But to see them up 3 kills right off the bat and not missing a beat, that really surprised me. I noticed they fell a little bit short on wards, and they had a couple mistakes towards the late game, and I they were going back, they were watching the VODs, they're starting to scrim now, so hopefully we'll see you guys scrimming with them in the coming week, but it was exciting to watch, to say the least, just as far as a new team jumping into this entire mix, you know?
Oh, yeah. And we actually had a few in the chat room today ask for the sign-up, so we could be seeing possible, you know, new blood every week, which is great for the game, you know what I mean?
Absolutely.
I love it just for the meta factor, you know, just some team just doing something different that could totally just, you know, rock Curse's world, you know, round two. I mean, I love you guys, but I love to see you fail at the same time, you know what I mean? Because you're so good at doing good stuff.
Yeah, I mean, like, you guys have been undefeated, you guys took the PAX 10K, you guys have taken the first 6 out of the 7 weeklies, you took the launch event. We'll see tomorrow how you guys do with the monthly, but just to see a little change of pace is nice for once.
That's true.
I mean, don't get me wrong. You're not going anywhere. You know what I mean?
Oh,
like,
no,
exactly.
No,
you
course.
Know, like,
we're
I mean,
strong.
It's always going to be a really tough battle. It's right now, I still feel it's going to be that Curse versus Root for a while. You know what I mean? Like, I think we need more gods, and we definitely need a lot of new blood, you know, Denial, making some waves for sure.
Yeah, definitely.
Worth It, definitely another team that I love to see do well. So, I mean,
they've been consistently taking third. This was the first week in a while that they took below third. They finished fourth this week to the Copenhagen
Seawolves. Seawolves!
Yes, the Copenhagen Wolves take a break. They come back, and out of nowhere, they pull third. So exciting to watch. They had an interesting last game. They built, like, 4 gods with second item defensive they built. So essentially, like, 4 bruisers is what they seemed like they were aiming for. And it paid off for them. They did really well. They had something like 14-3 kills at the end of the match.
Yeah. We've seen that from them since their early days too, back before they were Copenhagen Wolves, where they really like to go 3-tank or just build really tanky teams.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Which yeah. With a bit of a tank meta, I can understand where it's coming from. Definitely interesting to see. It threw me off when they threw the Aphrodite Odin combo. It was so exciting for me.
Yeah, that was kind of a something new.
I've been asking for Aphrodite Odin for quite some time now. So
yeah.
Or not just Aphrodite Odin, but Aphrodite in general, because she hasn't really been in the competitive scene yet. And I see that.
I usually would picture like Aphrodite laning with like a more aggressive bruiser, like a Thor or someone, just to get really big damage. With
yeah, Aphrodite Thor lane is very strong.
Yeah, that's a very strong. Oh yeah, that passive on Thor for sure.
I just like the thought of like Aphrodite sitting back, and I'm submitting one of the top plays this week was Odin leaps tower dive straight in. Aphrodite chills out with the minion wave, uses her doves to put some damage onto this Hades that the Odin tower dives, and uses her back off. Odin drops his three and finishes him off. Like, right then and there, it was like a perfect dive. They took him from half health.
Yeah, I mean, Aphrodite can really do some surprising amounts of damage, especially for a little magic power.
Yeah.
Personally, I don't really like to build her tanky. I think she's much stronger as a mage or something like that.
Now, like, in that game, I think she did close to 20k healing and only 9k in damage. Do you think that's something that's going to be kind of the norm for her in competitive play, or that is something that just was more situational going with Odin?
I mean, I think that typically her healing is going to be higher than her damage, just because...
I would agree.
Every time she doves, she gets the healing no matter what, and maybe
She was 10k player damage off from almost every other player on her team.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I didn't see that game. Like, I don't know exactly how she built, but, like... If we get more med, like, a lot of people build Aphrodite pretty tanky, like Shadow is saying, but if we get some people building her, like, way more aggressively, we might see her damage start to rise.
That's what I think, too.
So, Shadow, we have a viewer who's curious why you're not in your bathroom.
I'm not on campus right now.
Otherwise, that makes sense. When you're on campus, there's a sink right behind you. That adds up.
Exactly.
That is his bathroom. He lives in the bathroom.
That would be a nice bathroom.
So, one thing I did want to touch on that I noticed all of Curse doing for their tanks. You guys have been building the starting item, Bracer of Replenishment, I believe it is. And, no, that's Lobster Tail, isn't it?
I don't think any of us really like... Yeah, we all get Vanguard on tanks.
Vanguard, sorry, that's what it was, not Bracer.
Yes.
Then you go into the damage boots rather than reinforced or celerity.
Mm. On someone like Gwan or Odin?
I noticed it for all the tanks that I saw you guys play today.
Yeah. I personally only like it on Gwan or Odin. Sparks is really our defensive tank, so it makes a little more sense for him to build more damage-y. Right now, you just got to choose the boots based on what exactly is happening in the game. Like, basically every single boot is viable for all gods except, like... Obviously, not Magi boots for physical gods.
The 80 gods.
Like, yeah, sometimes
we
you just need
more
damage.
We do have a special crowd, but they're not that special.
Exactly.
It was just very interesting and surprising to see it, like, going from... It used to be they would get reinforced, and that was what happened. To now you guys are mixing in the damage with it.
Yes.
So it was a little bit exciting to see it.
Yeah. A lot of the time, the damage is really necessary to get on tanks, especially on Odin, who's already, like, inherently tanky.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
Or, I mean, not that Vox is usually available, but, like, if Mage Boots and Bacchus can work great, like, Vox's damage can be so high.
Yeah. He does a lot of damage with his ulti and, like, his entire kit.
Oh, yeah.
Or, Bess makes a good point. If you do Magi and Warrior Tabby, you could do one boot for each foot.
There you go, Bess. You're absolutely right.
Then you get, like, 7.5 pen for each, so there you go.
Yeah.
Yeah. Perfect for Freya.
There you go. That hybrid.
New meta.
So are you going to be running that when you play Odin next week, ShadowQ?
I'll get all the boots.
Okay.
That'd be the funniest thing in the world. It really would be.
I wound up
getting all the boots, right?
I had random queue a week or so ago, and I was with, like, two friends. We wind up against Root. All of them.
Ouch.
Did you win?
I was like, did you? No, but I wound up positive at the end of it all, so I was happy.
So basically, he just stayed back at the base. He didn't leave the fountain.
We had two randoms that fed, and the rest of my team turtled the entire game and made them frustrated with the passive play. But we all bought boots, and that was all we bought. We went Celerity into Warrior Tabby into Reinforced into Magi, and that's just how we played that out.
Wow. That troll, dude. That's too good.
And I bet your end game was super amazing.
Hey, we didn't make it to the past the 11-minute mark.
Gotcha.
But I was quite entertained with it. So, rolling forward with our topics, if I could remember what the next topic I had was...
So, Mace, do you ever get angry and just go play the piano back there? Because I see it. And you look like a piano player.
No, I don't play piano.
So, who's the piano for then?
No one, really.
It's just there.
Much. It okay. Really is.
Okay.
I don't know. It's just been there.
I'm sure someone had hopes for a piano player, but now it's just like a really big coaster.
Okay, so let's touch on some expectations you guys have. As the LOL community is moving over, I always get excited to see the posts on the Reddit. Oh, I'm coming over from LOL. I'm
new.
Yeah, what differences are there?
Those are really frequent.
And yeah, a lot.
I'm always happy to see them personally.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Do you think that as a lot of the competitive teams move over from League of Legends, Dota, Han possibly, hopefully not, just saying, do you think that we're going to see a lot more competition for, like, Curse, Denial, like, all the teams that are already up there? Do you think they're going to have a harder time now that some of the competitive teams are really making the push over to Smite?
I mean,
I think over time they'll like get used to the game, and obviously if they're like top teams in League or PON or whatever, they're probably going to eventually be really, really good at the game too.
I know PON finished like
that's just a matter of time.
2300 season 1 of League of Legends, like he was top 200 or something like that.
Mm-hmm. I mean, most people who are pretty competitive like in one game just can really translate that over and like master the next game. I mean, it'll take time for sure. Like they need to get the game, play probably a couple hundred games before they're really ready to break out necessarily, but it's gonna happen.
I mean, I had we did a tournament at the Intel LAN Fest a few, I guess January, so a couple months now, and we had a competitive LOL team that got knocked out really early in the tournament because they had a DC from their offsite member. So
that's really disappointing.
Yeah, they had the rematch wasn't like something they could make. They paused it. But this guy's internet went out or something. So they started playing Smite on the demo machines we had set up. And we did a little bit of a Smite tournament. And I watched a active like team of Smite players, guys that are like level 15 or so, get their butts handed to them by the LOL team that had been playing for 3 hours.
Yeah, that'll
happen.
It was
absolutely insane. And these guys each picked up a god, they figured out who they liked, and they went straight into it. And they won the tournament, actually. They all won god packs. So
very nice.
I think as we see the LOL teams moving over, I'm going to say that you guys might really be getting a lot more competition.
I would expect so, too. Yeah, if they're really good at League of Legends, they already know a lot about positioning and like when to go places and like when to do objectives. Like they already know general coordination.
I mean, they had communication that made the, like, you guys, I'm sure you guys saw Reason Gaming, some of the older games they used to play, and they had the communication that was like none other. They were constantly fluid conversation. They had the VGS and the voice going. These guys had that, but on a higher level, and it was scary to watch. Like, it was like machines playing. It was crazy.
Yeah, the amount of communication some teams have in, like, those, like, in the communities that are more developed is just insane. I mean, well, Shadow and I both played World of Warcraft before Smite. Like, we did hundreds of arena games together, and... yeah, probably. But, I mean, this is just kind of a parallel, even though this isn't as much of an esport, but, like, the top grade teams in WoW, like, their communication is just insane if you listen to any of that.
Yeah.
Just, like, 20, like, 5 people talking at once, and they get what every single person's saying.
Mm-hmm. I've been there.
So
that's a lot. That takes a lot to do. I would love that ability while we're casting to like just tune in to what you guys playing just to hear like little snippets.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like just to hear like that, you know what I mean? Oh, especially in like really big team moments, I'd love that.
Yeah, the cheers of victory and whatnot, just to get that audio clip of yes. So next topic, you guys are our guests. I want to touch on a little bit more of just your opinions, your thoughts on this game. I asked you before the stream started, and I wish I could have gotten them in here. Your favorite gods, Mace, you said yours was Anubis. Shadow, you said yours was Bakasura, actually. And you're,
yes.
I just want a little insight on why that is, what brought you to that point. Because, I mean, well, I guess for Shadow, Bakasura?
Back in the day before the map was even changed, like back when they had side lanes in the jungle,
full-time
it was
jungle.
My favorite. Yeah, it was my favorite thing to just full-time jungle as Baka, like get Hand of the God, first item Frostbound Hammer, and just roam freely. You could just gank so many people. It was just really fun to play. I liked his playstyle a lot.
Okay, understandable. And Mace, what brought you to Anubis?
Well, like I was first starting the game, and I was looking to buy my first god, like the first god that's not the default.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I faced this Anubis at mid, and he just 100-0'd me, and I was like, wow, that is the most overpowered god in the game.
And
he killed me with one move. Wow, like that is broken.
Back in August, Anubis was so strong, and like his cooldowns and everything got retweaked right afterward, but
yeah,
that was a little bit after I had started working at Hi-Rez. It was like I started the week before Anhur came out, actively working, and it was like Anubis was the god you played. I learned Anubis just because he was so strong. He was my best god, and I won like every match I played as him.
Yeah, I mean, what I did is so I bought him, and then like I started doing ranked, and I just was on a kick for a while. I just played Anubis every single game. Like, yeah. I like him. I like that you can just, like, go in if you can. It's all about if you can land the stun. Land the stun, 100-0 them. If not, then you're done.
I remember
Run away!
Not play Anubis just because how bad the average person was at him.
Yeah.
It was something that was a little bit expected because everyone was like, oh, I'm going to play him because he's so good. And then they wound up not being that good as him because they didn't know how to play him.
Yep.
So, how did you two, I know you guys play the same games together, you hang out, you enjoy games with each other, I'm sure, being brothers, but how did you two wind up both becoming very competitive and professional at Smite?
Well, I guess at the very start, it really goes back to WoW, like, way back when we started doing 2v2 together, and, like, we got really into it, we got competitive, we eventually got really high after, like, a ton of games, and, like, we both played a little bit of League. We never really got into that. And eventually I saw a new game on Twitch. Like, someone was streaming Smite. I had never heard of that before. And I saw that it was just like League, except with the perspective of WoW. And I was like, oh my god, we have to play this.
We were like, it's WoW and League combined. Even though it's basically just League.
It's the popularity of League, mm-hmm. but it had the viewpoint of, like, World of Warcraft, that third-person aspect. That's what really hooked me. Like, I was competitive, as weird as it's going to sound, Super Monday Night Combat player.
Mm-hmm.
I played that very, very, like, religiously. I was the number six Captain Sparks player when I was actively playing, which, like, he had the highest skill cap as an assassin. And I could get in, get a triple kill, and get out before people realized I was there. Before he got noticed, but that's at this point another story. It was the chain grapples all day, but so I saw Smite and I was like, not only was I excited because I knew the guy who's like the whole reason I got into Hi-Rez was I knew the guy whose father owned the company. I grew up with him. That was like my entire way of getting this job, what I do for Hi-Rez and what I do for the community. But I was like, oh my god, this is like Super Monday Night Combat with the aspect of LOL that all my friends are trying to drag me over to.
Yeah.
And that's what, like, that was what sold it for me, and that was why I moved over to Smite.
I mean, I think the view, like, it really makes it feel like you're more in the action. Like, you can
absolutely.
See everything that's going on a lot more. I mean, maybe it's just because I don't really know the stuff in League, I don't really know everyone's abilities, but when I was playing that, it just kind of seemed like, okay, I go in, and then it's just a big cluster.
Yeah.
Like, it's a lot easier to see what is happening in Smite. I mean, obviously, especially since I know what's going on now, but...
Yeah, there is a bit of a learning curve, memorizing all the skills, figuring out what everyone does.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess it is that transition, mostly, but I... Like, just seeing more of the community moving over and playing is, like, the most exciting thing this community's been growing in.
Yeah.
Lionheart made the video. It's one of the most touching things in the world to watch, at least from a, like, Smite community members' perspective. Like, we do have this giant family that is Smite.
Oh, and yeah.
It's yeah, so
the community's
nice
really good.
That.
Yeah.
I feel so like a lot of the players are a lot more respectful than, at least from what I've experienced in other games.
Let's hope not too many League players come over. No.
See, no, though, I don't mind the League attitude. Players.
Yeah, I don't mind League.
I mind the Han. The
yeah.
Oh, my God. I had a Han player in a game with me at once, and it was like, I called it from the second he started talking. I my comment was, go back to Han, please. And he said, why? And I was like, oh, my God. I found out that's the reasoning behind why the VGS system works. The, the exists,
the
not works,
teammates.
But...
What?
The owner of the company plays League of Legends very competitively, and he played Han when he was trying to, like, as they were starting the MOBA, like, community, the game, the whole aspect, he was trying to get ideas from other MOBAs to figure out what he liked best, and he played Han. 3 rounds, he got vote kicked out of 2 of them and cursed out of the other one. And he said, I will never have this in my game.
Yeah.
The VGS system took place, and that is why that exists.
Yeah, I mean, it's a really good system.
It helps so much. Like, when I first saw that, we were just like, that's the best thing ever.
It's,
that needs
it's
to be
really,
in every game.
Yeah.
It's not just, like, good. It's just kind of necessary for games like that,
yeah.
To be honest.
Especially
how do you feel about the move with putting the gods as their voices? Like, did you ever make that change in the file and, like, have, like...
Yeah,
I
tried it out for a few of
that'd
them.
That'd be awesome.
It's really cool.
Especially if, like, if you can tell what person on your team is saying something just by the voice, that would be really cool.
That would be so ideal.
Awareness of where it's coming left or right, you know what I mean? Yeah, definitely.
So yeah, I just wanted to get your opinions on some of that stuff. What god are you both looking forward to most, in your opinion? Just like any god, if you could see put into the game, what would it be?
I think that Kronos would be cool.
Okay.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
Like, just some kind of alt. Like, I don't know. There could just be some really cool moves, like, with time. Like, maybe an ulti that, like, rewinds or something like that. I think just like, you could do some really cool stuff.
That netcode, though, would be so tough.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know what would be actually viable, but...
The netcode would be horrible.
It'd be impossible to have everyone
yeah,
go
I'm
back
to sure it would, but
yeah, I mean,
theoretically, that would be a really cool god to have.
Yes,
something along
yeah.
those lines. Epic. Time
yeah.
controlling.
Now, if you could freeze everyone in yes, for a certain amount of time, that could probably work. Because then you're,
yeah.
like, freezing time,
yeah.
basically.
It would have to, like, freeze your teammates also, though. Otherwise, it would just be...
Yeah.
That could be cool.
Great for securing
you could troll. You could troll so hard with that. Like, go into your team fight, be ready and everything. Just freeze and leave all your teammates to die.
See ya, guys.
There would always be one person alive, at least.
That's true.
Oh, my God. That would be so entertaining.
That gotta be... Kronos would be really cool to add.
Okay, Kronos. Interesting. It's always interesting to hear, like, people's opinions. I know one of the most requested ones for some reason. I don't know why. I never actually heard of the god till recently was Fenrir. He's been requested left and right.
Oh, yeah.
It's because there were rumors that they were adding him for a while.
I could see that. Like, I mean, there were a ton of gods found in the old files. There was, like, stuff for people that I never even heard of going into the game. Like Yenlo Wang was supposedly found. There were models and stuff leaked for him.
Yeah, I remember that.
I've
that model was weird. It was like a stick. It was like just kind of a stick humanoid
yeah.
kind of thing.
I've never seen any files remotely close to his existence, which is why I'm like, wait, what?
Yeah.
Because I've seen a lot of the files and everything at Hi-Rez, and it's like there's nothing for him that I have ever witnessed.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, very cool. Very
yeah.
cool. Yeah, Fenrir, I mean, I believe also in the patch that came out, the data miners did find some more information on him. No models or anything, but just more, you know what I mean, text information about him.
Really? I haven't been in the office in like a week and a half. So
don't
I'm,
lie to
I'm
us.
So
don't lie to us. He knows it all. You know what I mean? He really knows.
Nothing. Actually, I don't even know what the new god's ultimate is because they decided they wanted to change up a bit of his kit. So,
well,
I'm, like, out of the loop on
like,
everything.
And that is the most feminine-looking male in
yeah.
the world.
Oh, it is. I'm still skeptical that it even is a male, to
yeah,
be honest.
People on
yeah.
the Smite forums are, like, guessing in the beginning, like, which it is, and, like, apparently the Warlords can be either way, so people were just like, what? Which is it going to be?
It looks like that one chick from Street Fighter, and I can't remember her name, but that's who she looks like to me. And I can't remember her name. I must find her.
I know who you're talking about.
Epic artwork HD. I don't know if you guys saw that, but my mind has been blown.
Yeah, I did. That's some pretty amazing artwork there. I honestly couldn't do anything better than that.
I don't think Smite will ever have anything remotely close.
Oh, wow. This is amazing. I like the Artemis. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
I feel something coming over me. That Aphrodite, man. I'm thinking...
Oh, my God.
So we're going to wrap up the show, guys. I need a little bit of time.
Right. Last question I really had for you guys as a person, like my personal questions. The new area map. Thoughts, opinions, do you like how it's
gosh,
designed?
Oh my gosh, I love it.
I'm actually, when we get off of here, I'm going to play it. Like, I've been wanting to play it all damn day. Like, ugh.
It's
so addicting. It should not be addicting.
Oh,
and
I agree.
It is. We both did, like, a lot of AGM just, like, on the normal Conquest map before this was out, and it just goes kind of stupid with how small the lane was. Like, if you were Melee, you couldn't do anything. It was just, like, all mage harass. Poke was all that mattered. But with this, it's so much fun. It's just everyone can get in a fight. And then every single game starts, you both get to mid lane, five sitting there, no creeps. One person gets a move off, and then chaos breaks out.
Yeah, yes. Dude, every time. Somebody's dying.
Every single ulti pops at once, and then
it just
goes crazy.
So it's usually a tank. In my games, it's always the tank that dies first. Like, Sobek will go in charge, and then it's like, we're going to fuck you up, Sobek, and then it's on from there. But
then it's often like one kill, and then it's just like three people from both teams down within 5 seconds.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Then the creeps come and everyone's like, all right, let's play passive. This is getting crazy.
Everyone back up. Reset lanes. Run away.
Usually people are so aggressive, but I had one game where, like, all that happened was the enemy team, like, sat under their turret. They were, like, turtling all game.
Where's the fun in an ARAM where you play seriously?
I know, right?
Yeah, really. Come on.
It's like Arena, but, like, less... serious, because it's all random.
I was playing an AGM with Dolt, one of Denial's members, and he just was Agni. He just was like, you know what, I'm going to build Fizz.
I did see a YouTube video of the same Asgard map, but in an arena style, and had, I think, two towers on each side of the map, and then it still had the buffs as well, like on the outside,
really
just like
cool.
They do now for Arena. Yeah, I think that'd be interesting, because then you don't have to worry about Loki constantly coming around. You know what I mean? Like, it gives you more of that you have to fight forward versus just constantly getting ganked in the butt.
So I'm enjoying the ARAM map. Hopefully we'll have the Godly Bravery working pretty soon. Spoilers.
You gotta get on that.
Getting the API sometime this week to get started on that and get the map uploaded and updated as soon as possible for us. Or not map, but site working.
Yeah.
It'll be a little bit boring as far as the graphics go for the first week.
Well, yeah, as long as it works.
It'll work. It'll give you builds.
I will love you forever, Santa.
Say that again.
I will love you forever if you do that successfully.
Okay.
That'd be the best thing.
Ultimate Bravery, so great.
I've had enough requests for it that I'm like, I can hang out at home and code that this week. Although, I don't know if it's going to happen this week because it wound up that I'm teaching a lifeguarding class, which is why I won't be here for the monthly finals tomorrow. Mm. So.
How long does it take people to not drown?
You know what I mean? Like, 24 hours, roughly.
You know? Like, hey, that person didn't come up. Let's go after him. You know what? You're going to pass, buddy. You got this. So sit him down, have him watch a season of, like, Baywatch.
Hello,
done.
Good morning. You passed the test. Goodbye. I'm going home. And I'll just bolt for my house. It'll work. Yeah.
Like, I would just walk in, just do a backflip, and say, what?
And then just walk out?
Yeah.
I would pay money to see you do a backflip.
Ah, you don't want to see me do it. I'd probably break something. Like... the board.
That's why
they
call break dancing.
I see what you did
that
there.
Hunts.
But yeah, thank you guys so much for coming on with us.
Thank you.
Yeah,
it was fun.
Really happy to have you guys here. Hopefully, we'll have you guys back in the future. Get some more competitive players in here with us and chatting and Maybe one day we'll have, like, just a giant panel of, like, 50 people talking. Who knows?
Just every person that's on a team.
Yes.
That's crazy.
We'll have all the teams ever. We'll get Arena Tank even.
Everyone except
even Arena Tank.
No, don't get crazy.
Okay.
Oh, the BM from Arena Tank would just come out all over. He wouldn't shut up. You know he wouldn't, too. That's why I love
Sherby
Arena Tank.
And him to yell at each other, even.
We don't
that
need
would be interesting. Okay, so thank you both for joining us. Everyone, thank you for hanging out. First episode of Into the Fountain. We'll be back next week about the same time, roughly 45 minutes after the Curse tournament ends for the weekly tournaments. We'll be doing this every week. Graphics are going to be improving with weeks to come. Just kind of getting everything set up, and we wanted to get everything started and see how it went this week. So thank you all for coming out, hanging out with us. And I hope you guys have a great week. We will see you next Saturday around the same time. Definitely the same place. Shout Nation. Thank you both, ShadowQ, Q, and Macetodaface. If you want to plug your Twitters, Twitches, this would be the time. So Shadow, if you have any shout-outs, plugs, all you.
Yeah, sure. I'll type my Twitter name in chat. If you could follow me, that would be awesome. And yeah, that's about it.
Awesome. Mace,
I mean, I guess I'll just put in my Twitter that... Yeah, I'm just at Macetodaface. That's all I am.
He's at Lil Cutie. Or at I play the piano when I'm lonely.
Just watch next week. My kill count on Mace is going to just go way up.
I'm waiting. Now that we have this like fuel on your fire, I want to see who has the kill count at the end of the week.
Oh, and if you see in the background, if you guys, I just saw on the stream, it caught my brother in the background. That's our brother that doesn't play Smite.
What?
Yeah. Wait,
there's
what
a third.
That's a pretty cool shirt. Let's be honest. That was a pretty cool. You know what I mean? Yeah, I feel almost like he knows karate just by him wearing that shirt.
Possibly. I could see that taking place. So also, guys, if you enjoyed the show, if you want to come back and hang out with us next week, please be sure to follow the Shout Nation channel. There's streams all week. Decoy doing a great job keeping the art up. Bulldog. Also an amazing guy, good caster, great streamer. So be sure to come hang out, visit them, visit the entire Shout Nation crew.